Welcome to our meeting, a few members of the public as well. So the first item on the agenda before we do anything else, the election of a chair of the committee. So in terms of nominations, do we have any names? I'd like to put Peter's name forward. Peter's done a tremendous job in terms of the drive and energy required for getting Northbridge and the neighbourhood plan through to the state it is now. I feel personally that we have an awful lot of big tasks on this committee for the next 12 months, and we need a bit of energy, so you know, I'd like to think that Peter's name.
I'll second that, I'm not going to handle it for it.
Thank you. Okay. Are there any other names? Okay, well, with one on the table, we can take it to the vote. All those in favour?
Thank you very much.
I can shut my computer down.
Do I have to do this?
You are the chair. Your first task is upon the deputy.
Okay, so.
I didn't say elect one, I said find one.
Election of a deputy chair, please. Any nominations?
I'd like to nominate Ian.
Good idea. Ian's nominated. I second it.
Can I make a move against? No, it's too late. No, I would happily deputise for Mr. Peel, as long as he doesn't ask me to do anything.
I need you to set the meeting tonight.
So you're in charge now, Peter, if you know, keep us, what's the next step?
Oh, do apologise, I'm sorry.
We've got a proposer and a seconder.
We've got a proposer and a seconder. All in with those in favour, please? Unanimous.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right. Apologies for absence.
I had apologies from Councillor Glenn.
Do we accept those apologies?
Yes.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Right, declarations of interest. Now, do I have to read all through this, or does everybody know what it is?
Yes, I
do.
Are there any declarations of interest that you wish to put forward, anybody?
I don't think I've got anything on this agenda, but if it comes up later,
yeah,
on,
you can always do it out as it comes up.
Do it posthumously.
Well, the next point then is the representations from interested parties, which I am assuming.
Sorry, it's okay. No, I'm jumping ahead. It's fine.
So I'm assuming that you wish to talk to us about bicycle ways,
bicycle parking. We just wanted to give you a quick update on where we're at. See the timeline for the money is running out. So I'll just pass around these, which is a quick summary. I don't know if I've got enough for everybody. Yeah, we've made some good progress. Obviously, you approved this at the last council meeting. We have in total 12,718 to spend. I've now had a quotation from Masement Amstad for a number of racks that were included in, you recall, but there's phase one and phase two. And that, excluding VAT, comes to 8,331. We've already purchased some portable racks, which we've now used at the last at the Vintage Festival a couple of weekends back, and also used at a bicycle event. What I would like to ask about that is where you would like them to be advertised. So I was thinking you could probably put them maybe on the council website, maybe on Oundle Info, but also directly to any other sports club. What we originally agreed was that they were going to be stored in the QVH. My only concern is that they're there and someone's got to get them. I do have another proposal which sounds would be, I would manage them for you if you were happy with that, and you would direct people to me. I work in my workshop 6 days a week, so people could come and collect them from me if they wanted, which might be more convenient than putting them in the QVH. But it's up to you guys, really. They will be a town asset, so we do want them to be used by the town, not just for me personally. But yeah, there are.
Well, I know it's not an agenda item here, but I think that's a very good idea.
Yeah, so
a better idea.
The one thing I would actually say is that you go away on holiday for what, a month at a time, don't you?
Not usually, no. Normally in the summer.
Yeah.
I probably only have a week. Last year I did a long ride, but
that's where I was going.
That's unusual for me. I don't normally go.
So it's only about a week?
Usually in the summer, because that's my busy time, to be honest.
Yeah, yeah.
But if it was, you know, did come up at some point in time, they're not actually that big. They could maybe be stored here somewhere if you wanted.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's up to you guys, really. But yeah, they are a town asset.
How does that affect our insurance, if at all?
If they are going to be ours?
Yeah.
Yes.
I would have to find out. I think
just that it's
their
ours, but they're stored somewhere else.
Yeah.
Mm. In my workshop, I would have them covered by my insurance, because
mm-hmm.
I do have customer things stored in my workshop, which I have to be covered by my insurance.
Where would they have been if they had been in the QVH?
The idea was to put them underneath the staging, but...
Oh, right, okay. Actually, build.
I don't know that we actually agreed to that. I know you suggested it, and I think your plan is a much better one.
Yeah. Well, I just think it's more accessible.
Yeah,
people can come to me. I'm there, like I say, 6 days a week, and if people want to borrow them, any of the local cycling organisations, then they can come and collect them from me. I probably know most of the people anyway, so...
No, that's fine. If you're happy to do that and it works,
well,
they'll be insured.
I'll contact them.
I don't think there's a problem with that.
Okay. As long as you're in agreement. I think we do need to get them marked with some sort of asset number or something to make sure, and maybe UV mark them just in case they're nicked at some point or something. So I don't know. Is there a facility to do that here? Do you mark your assets or?
Not a pen, but we haven't got anything sophisticated. Haven't got any special.
Yeah, all right, we'll sort that out.
Yeah, but
So there is a further £3,625 to cover the Co-op QVH notice boards and St Peter's in the car park and the old courthouse, which on my calculations. I think we should be fairly well covered. Maceman have done a good quotation for us, and I think the install, I think he's doing us a big favour actually, because actually when you look at the number of racks that he's going to install, I'd be surprised if he could do it for that money really, so I think he's probably doing it at cost.
I think he's pretty much doing it at cost, isn't he? He did come to the meeting here and said that he's local and he wants to put something back into the community.
That's fine.
Have we got any designs?
We've got some designs. There's some. These are the designs of the hoops.
They're the off the shelf.
These are going to be. You know, where they're going to be. The idea is that they would be small enough to go outside the QVH. So there's an area that we identified outside the QVH. Where you maybe have either two or three of those, so you can stand your bikes up and look against them. Next door to that is, what's the name of that place?
Yeah, the Bazaar.
The Bazaar.
Yes.
The Bazaar. There are some there of those, that style. And then in the town area, we've got the five bar style racks.
This is a hanging rack.
Ali's illustration of the hanging style.
Hanging style for the big groups.
So there'd be one of those opposite the Greedy Pig, one of those.
Has that been okayed by the highways?
Yeah.
Right, good.
Yeah. One in the market, there'll be two at Barnwell, and the proposers are also to put one outside here, so for people visiting the cafe here. So that's those designed. Then he's also going to put in replacing the two, you know, the bent racks outside Tesco, so he's going to replace those bins.
Yeah.
So he's going to replace those two.
I think pretty much like for like though, isn't he? Because the holes are all
But in stainless, so they're all going to be in stainless because it's maintenance free and the paint doesn't chip on and things like that, so it stays looking nice. And then the last ones were two Sheffield style hoops. And then if you know the back of the church where the bins are stored, so the where the bin goes into there. And there are going to be some other racks alongside the church as well, but those, there's two Sheffield ones to go back there. But what we need to do is to raise the order to get them done. And to get
that's what the council agreed at the last meeting. Yeah. So we're getting them by. Yeah. And then for this committee, I think for the next time, we need a formal presentation, we just need a proposal for this committee. This at the moment is public participation, isn't it?
Yes, it is, yeah. Yes.
It's all been approved. I mean, this is more of an update, so just to say this is where we've got to, because, you know, actually it needs to be forwards, because otherwise we're going to lose the money.
Mm. Has the Diocesan Council approved the ones at the church?
Not yet.
You have to get their permission.
Yes,
I appreciate that.
That's the sort of detail I was thinking about. You know, we just need to go through each location.
Yeah. Well, a key thing was that actually, you know, we can place the order for them and then work out the details in terms of what we don't want to do is lose the money. So that's a key thing. Not to lose the money.
So once
we place the order, we will obviously make sure that there's details here, like, you know, the one we're planning to put behind the co-op. We haven't approached the co-op and had a conversation with the co-op either, so we need to do that. Mm. It's just a bit about time.
Okay.
That's it, really. Any other questions, concerns?
No. Thank you very much for your presentation.
Yeah. Just where the one at the marketplace was going to go. Did we tie that down?
Yeah, I think we're going to put it
somewhere near the camera is.
Yeah.
Opposite.
Yeah, on that side where it's out of the market.
Yeah, so it doesn't interrupt with the market itself, it doesn't interrupt the bus station.
We mustn't put them in front of the drop code.
We see an area there where there's going to be very little pedestrian traffic. Yeah, it isn't going to interfere with anybody trying to cross the roads. Yeah, excellent.
Okay,
brilliant. Thank you very much. So the next thing is the minutes of the previous meeting. Now, obviously I wasn't here, so we need people that were here to... write on this.
I was proposing the second.
And those that are here who can vote, please. I think that's the unanimous for the one thing.
Right, so the initial first page is going to sign the date.
Okay. Right, so, okay, courthouse leases, to approve new tenants for courthouse annex 3, first of all, this is Catherine Hicks, Juniper Playfair. Now, she has sent us a business summary on this. I've read through it. What I did do earlier today is I actually phoned up to find out what size Annex 3 was, because I had no idea. And it's 21.5 square metres, which is basically about the size of this room. Yeah. Now, she's proposing to have a therapy place there, which I think is a brilliant idea. and it should be welcome. But she also wants to put in a consulting room and a waiting area within that space. And the other thing I was worried about as well, and I did phone up and ask about this, is that there are no children's toilets in the courthouse.
That's right.
So, although I think it's a fantastic idea, I'm not sure if it's best suited.
Can I make, I've got obviously something to say about it, because this council supports an existing service in chat. And I think it would be very difficult and confusing, personally, to have the two, one free service, which is the chat one, and a paid for service, sort of in the next door room.
Are they in the same room?
Yeah, because CHAP provides these services. Yeah, yeah. And recently had a grant from the council in order to do further training.
I think this is quite a young conflict, but the point of that grant
is to do the younger children.
Right.
At the moment it's over eight, mm-hmm. but I just have to point this out. I'm not saying I'm necessarily objecting, but I'm saying that I think there's some room. I agree with your point about the size of the room, and we don't have anybody on the desk at the courthouse sort of seeing people in and out.
I think what she wants is just a small area, so where this partition is, so that when she's got parents that bring their child, the parents can sit there, and it's totally...
But it would have to be soundproof.
Well, yeah.
And then she would have to, if she left, she would have to take that down. She would, under the lease, she would have to restore.
I mean, she's been and had a look at the room. Yeah, I appreciate it that. Through.
I disagree with Peter, but I'm not sure it's.
I mean, there are toilets there. There are female.
Yeah, but they're not toilets. Especially for children, are they?
But CHAT haven't got special toilets for children either.
No, they haven't.
I mean, I don't know the law, and I'd have to sort of take your advice on this, but. As far as I understand, you are supposed to have toilets that are suitable for younger people if you've got some sort of therapy or class type situation.
It might depend on, what sort of thing it is.
So I don't know, so that's what I'm saying. I have no idea.
So working back and just answering.
Well, again, I mean, yeah, she's seen what facilities there. Mm. I mean, I would assume that she probably knows more about that sort of thing. I mean, do CHAT know whether they've. They must know whether they've got to have appropriate toilet facilities.
I don't know.
It would depend on the age of the building and the type of the building, because I've had this in the past with shops, that you are exempt if it's physically impossible to provide those facilities.
I'll certainly go back and ask questions.
I think it's a fantastic idea, and I would approve it, but I don't. I'm a little bit worried about the size of the room and the fact that I thought you had to have special facilities for children, especially if there's any sort of therapy where they might have to go, A, as a quiet room, and B, somewhere where they can actually go to the toilet in private away from adults.
But their parents will be there, so their parents will take... Yeah, they're going to be... They're small children, they're not going to be there without their parents.
Oh, well, the parents aren't going to be
with the therapist. So if they do need to go to the toilet, then their parent would take them to the toilet, which is what I would imagine happens.
Yeah, they'd have to go outside wouldn't they?
Yeah. No, they've got toilets in the annex.
Oh, have they?
Yeah, on the ground. There's a kitchen, two toilets.
Have they produced as yet the documentation they have to have to say that they've been checked?
What, DBS check? Yeah. I haven't seen their DBS.
It would have to be safeguarding.
I don't think she would get this far without.
Well, I think you can't make an assumption.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we can ask for that as well. Yeah, we can ask for that.
And I think we would need to know that she'd be able to pay the rent, because. I mean, she can't go in and poach children from the primary school and things.
Well, according to her business plan, she has got a loan of £15,000.
I know, amazing. Because that's all a business plan that she's given to us.
Yeah, and
tells us nothing.
Not really, no.
So do we get a business plan for everybody who goes in there?
Sorry. Yeah, we don't.
Do we have a business plan for everybody who we let rooms to?
We do, don't we? No, we've not had a business plan.
They're actually a facility.
I mean, I think she sent this to send a bit more information, and I think this is possibly something she's had to fill out for that grant.
Yeah, unfortunately.
I would say.
Oh, I see, you've got more, have you, there?
Yeah, I don't know what you got. I think this is what she had to complete for the grant.
So my view is this straightforward commercial proposition. She wants to rent a facility off us. Yeah, we haven't got an objection to her renting the facility off us, but yeah, and it's if she does alteration, she puts it right at the end, and she pays. Do we take monthly in advance on rent?
Yeah, so she pays deposit.
In advance, and she can't expect us to change any toiletry facilities. So she needs to double check.
I'll ask for that, and a DBS check. Are we obliged to do the DBS check?
Is that our responsibility?
No, we're not. She's renting a room off us, that's all.
Yeah, exactly.
We're not a partner in her business.
No. Is she paying for the alterations?
Yeah, she said that she will pay.
So I'm assuming that she could actually just send us a copy of the DBA check anyway, can't she?
DBS check. Yeah, she's got it, yeah.
Provided there's no comeback on us in any of that, there isn't a problem.
Well, no, there's no disagreement with anybody else's in there.
It's their job to register the people involved.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not us. We've got to register.
According to this, she's registered with the British or something of play therapists, so she'll have met their standards.
So are we okay with that?
Sorry, two other things in my mind then. First off, is the noise and the other tenants. Is there likely to be any, you know, because when the children start playing.
Yeah, the other tenant that's in there is Simex. He'll be in one of the other rooms.
He's probably not there half the time anyway, is he?
I think we need to make a point
about noise. Whatever this activity is that she's been involved in, you cannot.
I think it's therapy through play, you know, when they
say. I know exactly what it is. It's what we've had the grant from the council for.
And whether or not it's right for us to take a deposit for the restoration of the building, you know, our concept.
Well, we hold that deposit.
Well, we hold a £500 deposit anyway.
Will that be enough to take down all the partitions she's put in?
I don't know. Not sort of looked into how much that's even going to cost yet, because we've got to get planning permission for it. Because that's your next point on the agenda.
Okay, so if she wants us to get the planning permission.
It doesn't actually cost us to do anything. For us to do it, but she's prepared to pay for it.
So I was just saying, in terms of deposit, though, you know, having had her fingers burnt with some other tenants.
The courthouse setup is quite well organised, really. How we deal with it, we take a deposit, they pay the fees, and
It's only the restoration, though, putting these stud walls in.
We may not even get it for whatever reason. I don't know.
Over to you, Peter.
Well, no, that's fine. If we're all agreed on that, then do we approve the tenancy in principle?
You need a proposer and seconder.
I'll second it.
Okay. All those in favour? So, leading on to the next one, to approve a planning application being submitted for the stud wall. I'm assuming in that case, then.
This is for this room.
Yes, exactly. So, can I have a proposal and a seconder on that?
I'll second it.
In favour?
Yeah, that's good. Thank you very much. All right, the next one is to approve a tenant for the courthouse Annex 4, which is a little building company. I think most people have seen the vans around.
Which one's Annex 4?
That's upstairs, that's the smaller room. Okay. There are three rooms upstairs, swim acts are in one, the Juniper Play will be in one, and the opposite room. One of the rooms was what swim acts was using, but the other was a little storeroom that he was using. Yeah. that we didn't know about.
So, can I have a proposal for that?
I'll propose it.
I'll take the next
time. All those in favour?
We're working well.
Right, now, the next two, if I could take these two together and then separate them in a second. It seems that we've got to pay £500 towards the costs of the leases for the rugby club and the play there, Juniper Play, and the little Best Little Building Company.
This is to authorise that, well, because we've now said that you're allowing them to go in, this is their leases, produce their leases.
Right, it's all right, it's because normally, see, when you're doing a lease, it's the tenant that pays for the lease, not the landlords.
Yes, that's right.
So they're paying.
Yeah.
Oh, we're not paying. Mm-hmm. Oh, I thought it was good that we were paying.
No, that's what we do. Normally the tenants pay for the lease.
Right, so we're not paying the £500 or the £1,000.
No, not that I'm.
Oh, that's fine. Right.
When you say paying for the lease, are you talking about the legal fees here? Because
yeah. I thought we pay
for our side of the lease, and the other side pay for theirs. I thought.
We see normally, because I rent property, and it's normally the tenant that pays both.
I've never come across that, and I've had lots of
lease premises
in a variety of towns. And
yeah.
Well, I imagine we're not going to change the rules today, but...
No, I'll double check it. I'll double check.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I'll
I have
check.
A feeling these are the costs to us from our solicitor. Yeah. Yeah, to prepare the lease, to draft the lease from our side. Mm-hmm. Their solicitor will then have to look at the lease and consider it from their aspect. They'll then be to-ing and fro-ing while they... sort out the fine points, and then it'll come back to us for approval of a lease.
And it charges £500 a standard.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Except the rugby club will pay an extra £50.
Yeah. Well, I think
it's more complicated.
Is it? Yeah. I mean, that's quite.
I've been doing it for 500 years.
Really. Okay. So are we authorising this then?
Yes.
We have to have two votes. If somebody could...
I'll propose the first one.
I'll second it.
I'll propose the second one.
I'll
second
it.
Can we all vote
in favour?
Right, okay.
Second one.
You're taking
that
vote.
I've done it twice. Together, you
see. There we go. Right, yeah.
Don't forget, I'm not used to this.
Yeah.
Right.
Be careful, just a word of caution, if you put them together you might find we exceed our, we don't in this case, but we might exceed our
£2,000 budget.
Which might be why they're separated, so we just need to watch that one in future.
Okay, thank you. Right, next one, Snipe Meadow. Decide the next steps regarding the boardwalk, repair all the roof completely. The builders, as you can see, have recommended removal. At this time, to be honest, I think we should go with what the experts say.
And the question for me is, how quickly can we get the new boardwalk in?
Mm.
If that's going to take 2 years, then we must repair the
It shouldn't
the
take 2 years, because I know it has gone in for planning, but I don't know the outcome. And as of last week, we couldn't find any outcome, and I think Lisa was trying to speak to our architect.
I know we had an objection, didn't we, from English Heritage or somebody?
And then there was something about badgers as well. So I'm not quite sure where we're at with that.
What was the objection then?
There was a thing, I think English Heritage was one of those groups objected because of putting a boardwalk across a green piece of land, and what we couldn't understand is why they didn't know it was already there.
Mm-hmm.
It's already been.
But it's just an example of how these things go on and on and on.
I think as soon as we get approval, we can then look at replacing it.
So, in my mind, if we've got a chance of getting it in before the winter, then
the choice of materials they were arguing about, it was the fact that it's there at all.
Yeah.
Mm. Right.
But it is this question about repair or delay.
Yeah.
I can see they might say
it's stupid to repair it now and then rip it up 3 months later.
Yeah, and I think it needs...
But you have to leave that patch. You know, I'm embarrassed enough that I haven't chaired this thing for the last year, that we're in the position where we closed the boardwalk down. You know, I knew it was wonky, but I didn't know it was wonky enough to close it down. So I think it would be sad if we close that area off for more than 6 months.
Mm-hmm. Do we know how much removal would cost?
Well, I did speak to John about this, and he said that we could get community payback to lift, move it.
Oh, they'd love it.
So, but I think what we might have to do is remove all of it apart from the area nearest to the river, because that's where you have got the sort of stream bit, haven't you?
Yeah.
So we would have to leave something there.
So people would still be able to walk.
But the rest of it, particularly at the moment, which is pretty dry, is
So how dangerous is this thing?
It is, there's a lot of, it's in quite a bad state.
Mm, it is.
There are a lot of areas where it's literally, you know, broken timbers and the posts in the ground are broken.
Mm.
I mean, the insurance company, they agreed that we've done just about everything we could, and they'd even had a look to see where it was, but then they did say, why are you not removing it?
Mm. That's their advice. I think you've got to go.
Yeah.
I can't
so we'd leave a footpath there.
Well, what you could look into, and I think somebody from Andle said that before that boardwalk went on, it did have a sort of concrete, you know, bashed down.
Yeah.
So you could even think about doing that. And when we had the Wildlife Trust come out and have a look, he said, have you even thought about replacing it with something like that?
We had a quote some years ago now. Paul Piercy Hughes, Councillor Piercy Hughes, looked at it and had a quote, I think, from PGR.
It was thousands.
Oh, it was a massive amount of money to build it with hardcore.
Yeah.
In that sort of structure. And you've got to have pipes across all the way along it. You've got to have pipes every so often to let the water go from one side to the other, otherwise one side will become a lake. And the other side will be drained. So to drain the two into each other, you've got to have pipes under it. It was quite a construction. I think it was about 42,000 or something, from memory. From memory, and don't quote me on that, but that sort of order.
Well,
was what
I
it
think
was.
One of the quotes for the recycled plastic was about 70 odd, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, because we're going to go and get a grant for that, won't we?
We've got Section 106 money earmarked that you can use, £41,000.
Mm. But if we are going to boardwalk, I was down there last week, I took my capital book on it. It's got to be, I think, recycled plastic is the obvious choice. It's going to be there in 50 years.
Exactly,
time.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
why I wanted to
have this conversation again.
Yeah, whether one of these nature groups was complaining, whichever one it is, English Heritage or whoever, whether they were complaining about that kind of material, you know, oil-based materials rather than natural stuff, whether that's what their objection was.
Lots of stuff they do in Graph and Water and London is...
Yeah, stand base.
Yeah.
I went down and
they've
got boardwalks in plastic and they're really good.
Yeah, they
and you don't need that chicken wire over it because
brilliant.
They rough the surface so they're non-slip.
Yeah.
But they've got that installed in quite a few places.
Mm.
Yeah. And as far as ripping it up goes, we'd have to rip it up anyway to put the new one down, wouldn't we? So it's not really wasted money.
No.
But if ripping it up allowed people to get back to the river along that route, even if it's a fair weather thing.
Are they allowed to walk on there? Is there any... Because when I went down there, there's no sign of anything, just a map from English Nature, actually, someone on the left-hand side, showing the path.
Mm. Yeah.
But I don't know if there's any right of way or legal reasons you can't actually walk on it.
We've made it so it can be used by wheelchair users in the past. We even had passing bays on it so that wheelchairs could pass other people. I don't think you get two wheelchairs passing each other, but one of them would have to reverse all the way up the other one. But it is designed to be used by wheelchairs, so you might end up with a situation where we're now discriminating, if we're not careful. If you if you've got us something in a dangerous state for wheelchair users, but able-bodied people can still walk along there. I don't
know
where
they put their foot through it, and then they'll be in a wheelchair. Yeah,
it's like
when they put their foot through it, and then they'll be in a wheelchair. That's all we'll be saying.
Well, yeah.
But I think the answer is in the what's on the paper here.
Mm.
Builders who are there to make some money don't want to do it. Insurers don't want us to do it.
Mm.
For me, it's get it out.
We'd be on our own insurance wise if we went against.
Yeah,
I think well, we've got to come to a conclusion that obviously we need to take a position on this, and I think we've got to uplift it.
Mm.
I would then also say that it doesn't actually have to cost us any money because we can get the community people to do it for free.
Yeah. I can also ask, I've forgotten his name, but the guy that came from the Wildlife Trust, I think at one point they were going to come and present at one of these meetings, but then they didn't come. But I might just run it past them and say, look, it's in a really bad way, and we are
being
advised to lift it up. What do you suggest? Do you suggest we just lift it up and leave it that, or, you know, just ask what their recommendations are?
Why would we get somebody from Wildlife Trust to come and advise us on what's a
building
stroke civil engineering problem?
Yeah, but they advise us on Smike Meadow as well as, and it's the other group as well, Rural Lincoln, that we actually get the stewardship through. So we have to make sure that we're maintaining it. And so we've liaised both with the Wildlife Trust and the stewardship.
So we need these people on board for planning.
So can we say then in that case that we make a recommendation that we will remove the board subject to having talked to the two organisations that Emma asked to deal with? Is that okay?
I think a good idea to read the history of the bids and things and designs we have had.
Mm. Yeah.
Well, I can remember the plastic one. That was about 70,000.
Yeah.
That was
what I'd like to do immediately after approve of what you just said.
I think we'll just do that tonight.
We don't need to reinvent the wheel.
We need to get some pace in the
boardwalk. Let's see what we can do.
Can I volunteer to sort of put some pace on a bit?
Yeah, please do.
Well, I'm not happy with that, I have to say it.
Yeah.
Because that's just putting off something for another, when's our next meeting? 2 months?
No, we're not going to be putting it off. We're saying that we're going to be removing it, we're just giving notice to the people that, you know, we have to talk to, that we are removing it.
Okay.
Yeah. So we know we are getting on with it. Yeah.
We're not leaving. If we keep these people on board, we want to put something new on. You know, we're more likely to get a positive rather than a negative answer.
I'm happy to propose that we take it down, and I'm happy to propose that we approve those costs.
Mm-hmm.
Which of the two costs? Are...
There are no costs.
No, the costs are about mowing.
The
cost of
mowing.
That's the next thing. Okay, so, Paul, can we...
I'll second that.
Right, all those in favour? Smashing, thank you.
So, before you get on to the next one, though, I'd like it noted somewhere that we need some pace on this, the issue of
replacement.
Ian's going to be counselling
in
our
Well, I'll find out what's happening in the planning application as
well. He's going to get the first team cricket to
straight down there.
Down there with fast balls and throwing it down.
Yeah, but you didn't declare the interest at either, did you?
But I live near it.
Your cat.
it was just visiting. It was just visiting.
Yeah.
Got chased away by a dog.
Right, the next one, to approve costs of 6 and 8 plus condition 2, carry out required cutting of Stipe Meadow grassland. Can I, I wonder, should we just invite a farmer to cut it?
A farmer has done it in the past, but they don't collect, and what has been recommended to improve the flowers and everything else.
Right.
We need to have a cut.
It's got to be baled off.
Yep.
And if a farmer has it, there's fencing needs
Yeah, yeah.
That's the biggest
thing. So really then, if we're going to do, we're going to sort of, yeah. we might as well just go for this and do it.
Again, this is what's been recommended yeah. by.
Okay.
Wasn't there a condition at one time that we had to have it grazed by four?
We were going to buy a cow at one time, do you remember?
Four, it has to be yeah. four.
And there were all sorts of regulations.
Well, we can't yeah. get one.
No, it's not secure yeah. enough. They said a checkpoint, it's not yeah. secure enough.
Well, I got a couple of farmers.
So we found that Hanukkah found one and then they slaughtered it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, look, yeah. Can we just go ahead with the fact that we've got to get it done and yeah. so that we pay the bill? So, yeah. can I have a yeah. proposal, please?
Let's ask one question.
Yes.
We go with the top one with small bales. What's going to happen to the bales?
They're going to be taken away.
I think Lisa was. Has she written anything about that? She's yeah. yeah. wanted to find out whether they take them yeah. away or whether they leave them away.
They could put them around the rugby yeah. pitch so, for people to sit on.
Or just say, come and have a bail if you want, because lots of people need
yeah. Yeah. It is in there somewhere. I think well, one takes them away and one leaves.
Ready to cart away,
yeah.
if brackets, if conditions allow.
Mm.
Yes,
so,
we don't know.
Might go, might not go. Mm. Cut and bales and move to an agreed area. 100 quid less. Agreed area, what's that?
Well, in that case, that's yeah. exactly what Ian said. We could actually have it put near the gate and ask people to take them away if they want them.
They want to.
Well, that's £100 less.
No, that's they're going to put it to a pile for composting.
Oh, right.
So we say we want the pile over there.
Yeah.
And if they bail them, it's going to cost £100 more. But we could say, if you want a bale of hay, go and get one for free. Or sell them for £1 or whatever. But
well, it might stimulate interest in
yeah, exactly.
the project.
I think saying go and get a free hay bale is a good idea.
Get down there and
good idea.
Go on yeah. fishermen.
Yeah. And it would get people in the right area. Yeah. Mm. Show it there. So.
You know, I know lots of people with horses that would love to have bales of hay.
There's a particular weed that they don't like that grows in Amble, don't they?
Oh, what, the yeah, that yellow flower weed.
Yeah,
well, it's
rather. Yeah, I can see that one coming.
I think it's a horse, isn't it?
Haven't we got some... aren't there some preconditions about, because it's snipe meadow, the idea was it would be a nesting site for snipe and other similar birds.
Oh, time of year matters.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Time of yeah. year is one thing for the nesting cycle, and also I think the reason it was cattle grazing it and not sheep was sheep would graze it clean, whereas cattle would leave tufts. So it's something to do with the way that it's finished.
Yeah,
is important yeah. to the site as a natural site. So we might, if we do it wrong, if we do it in the wrong manner, we could end up with problems.
Okay. This, the company that we've got here is the company that they recommend that yeah. we use.
Right, yeah. that's okay.
The other thing with cows and things, with meadows and stuff, they crush and make holes, etc. Yeah. So the grass seed falls in and it regrows.
But that's probably what the snipe like.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
So, can we have a proposal?
I'll propose the hay bale option.
I'll second it.
All those in favour, please. Thank you. Okay, the next one. To prove cost of hiring reindeer, the Christmas market event.
I love
which,
this.
Which means I've got to go and get another Christmas tree. Okay, so does anybody have any objections to approve the cost of hiring a reindeer for a Christmas market?
Yep.
Why?
Well, why do we want one? What's the benefit of spending £1,000 plus?
I've absolutely no idea.
They're lovely, and children love them.
Hmm. I'd love them.
So there's the idea to draw people into the Christmas event.
It does draw a lot of people, doesn't it? I mean, I don't know if you've been there.
So how many more people are we going to get for our...
It's not going to pay
for £1,200 quid.
The reindeer themselves won't pay for themselves unless you're charging for rides on them or something. But how much did we make on the Christmas market last year overall?
Can't remember.
Income above expenditure.
We didn't make any profit this time because we have spent so much money on the
New lights.
On the marshalling. We're just about broke even, I think.
Right.
With a small amount of profit. But I think the store costs have gone up this year, so and we're also going to possibly rethink the marshalling. Because the vintage fair went quite well with volunteers. We're just going to start trying to get volunteers.
Yeah. So just for my mind, it's hard to do one item in isolation to the whole Christmas market.
Mm.
Yeah, because I know we were talking about the funfair that we had at the vintage market.
Yes,
yeah. Yeah, so you want to look at the whole Christmas market expenditure, give it a budget, don't you, really?
Yeah, the reindeer
are part of it.
Mm.
So,
is there any time constraint on
there? They get booked up.
Yeah, they're only running for a few weeks a year, aren't they? Probably 3 weekends and there's any interest in reindeer.
Because we couldn't get them last year because
we're too late. Right.
So have we got a budget for the Christmas market?
We have got a budget. I can't actually remember exactly.
It's got a reindeer subsection.
It comes under the
bottomless
under markets budget.
So in my mind, if we're going into tight budgets and it was a toss-up between the fun fair and the reindeer. The fun fair would probably keep more people.
The budget also works on the amount of income you get from the stores. So as that's coming in, we've got that money that we use. I don't think we've possibly put it, as I'm thinking about it now, an actual budget for the Christmas market.
Mm.
We use what comes in as the income from all the stores. And that's how it sort of breaks it even, or we can make a profit.
Where are these reindeer going to be?
We haven't decided exactly, but we're also going to be moving Farm Christmas, and he's going to have his own grotto, which my husband's company is going to make.
Right.
And so we're going to have that, and then the reindeer, and then for £120 more, they could bring a sleigh as well. So. It's a little bit where we currently have Santa's grotto.
Well, I do enjoy that.
Is upstairs in the QBH, so we're already. There's a lot of any children can't get up there. People with pushchairs, it's really not suitable. So we're thinking of bringing it outside as more of a centrepiece.
I've been a bit spoiled on that vintage market. I think it was such a wonderful thing. Therefore, we need to be at that level.
I know Lisa said about the fair.
And I think the reindeers are a great idea, but I wouldn't want to blow all my budget on reindeer.
Well, we are effectively.
Well, we do get in quite a bit more money than £1,000.
Yeah.
Mm.
So, can we come back to the proposition?
I'm against it. Especially as you've told me that we've no proper budget.
But we get all the money in for the stores. I mean, if you think the amount of money that we get in, and I mean, it's not something that you actually want to make money out of. It's an event that you're putting on for the town.
Mm. But you don't know whether you're going to make money or whether you're not going to make money. You're kind of making it up as you go along, because
we've
already spent £1,000.
We have a rough idea of the number of stores that we get, and it goes up every year. So you can have a look at what we had last year.
Yeah, my tendency is to say I'm in favour of it, in as much as, I think they are very special for Christmas, and we need to find some way of getting the budget under control, but because of the timing on this, knowing that if we leave it much longer, we'll lose that weekend.
If we have to book it now, is there a deposit or anything that we...
25%,
is it?
£250, that looks like.
Yeah. Plus an extra 30 if you have the sleigh. There's £280 committed.
Are we able to look at the next one? Because I think there's a time bomb sitting here in the lights contract, which mentioned...
But that comes under a separate budget.
Yeah, I think it's separate one here.
Yeah, it comes into the tourism.
I think it's whether we've got enough confidence on the reindeer to say that we can find the money somewhere between now and Christmas. I think we can. Mm. It might mean we have to cut something else out of the Christmas, and I hope we don't have to. The business community have been particularly good, so it's back into the whip round thing with them.
Mm. I think once is enough, to be honest. if somebody else wants to volunteer to go around the shop, they're quite welcome.
All right.
Sue and I got a lot of money last year.
Yeah,
and we got a lot of goodwill. But I think a lot of that goodwill might have melted away.
Okay. Must say I'm also uncomfortable with the fact that we're the first month into our new financial year, and already we're talking about spending money and having to try and find it from
the outlay
somewhere
what
else.
What we actually spent on the Christmas market is not a huge amount of money, because there isn't a lot.
The traffic thing last year, was that
that,
like
that was what was the lot, that
so as long
was
as we do
what the money,
4,000,
but we're
yeah.
contemplating not doing that this
yeah.
year.
So as long as we do that for less
yeah.
time.
And it's only for 4 hours, I see.
Mm.
But that's I mean,
that, that's, yeah.
I mean, 4 hours, that's the problem enough anyway, isn't it, really? I'm going to four,
well,
I mean, I don't know.
Well, the Christmas market, I mean, the stall holders are not set up, some of them, till about 12, but, I mean, they're arriving about 10. We're going to have to get these in, if they're in the middle of it all, we're going to have to get them in probably about 10, 11 o'clock. Which means by about 3 o'clock, we'll have had their 4 hours. They'll be wanting to come out in the middle of everything.
Well, we'll take that into consideration.
Right,
so that they are
right
ready.
Yeah.
We'll. Yeah.
Yeah. So you
look more spectacular.
They can fly out.
Arrives
yeah.
on the sleigh.
Yeah.
They can fly out.
Mm, fly it. That's it. Yeah.
Yeah. You're going on brandy. Is it worth doing as a trial, as a one-off this year?
Well, that's what I was thinking.
Well,
we'll just
yeah,
do it once, we'll see how it goes.
It might well be worth that, yeah.
If it doesn't work out, we've lost 1 year.
Yeah,
and just,
but
yeah.
I'm just thinking about this four-hour thing, because if they finish about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we're going on till about 6 or 7 when we do the light switch on.
I think what it'll probably try and coincide with our Father Christmas.
Yeah.
Because he
yeah, he's not there all the time
no,
either, is he?
He's only there for a short window, and then
yeah.
an hour or half an hour before the lights going to switch on, that closes anyway.
Yeah.
But I'm sure they could get the reindeer in through the crowds.
Well, if they can get them out, they can get them in later,
yeah.
can't they?
Yeah.
So if we book them for a later period...
They've got to be somewhere near... The
maybe about coming in at 3 o'clock
yeah.
and leaving at 7.
Yeah. We're going to have to position them somewhere near the war memorial or something so we can get them in down
yeah.
New Street into the middle of it, or through one of the back passages like the one next to Philip Hamps's shop. Get them in through.
Well, I think they come in with a trailer. They come in with vehicles with a trailer, so you wouldn't.
It's either Sussex Lane or
my
thought
was somewhere
at the
Talbot.
Yeah,
I
was
going
to say, get the
Talbot
to pay for it,
yeah.
and they could come in through the...
What about the ship? And the car parking at the back of the ship is handier than the Talbot.
Yeah, that'd be easy.
No, not car parking at the Talbot.
Sense for the ship, it's
perfect.
Yeah.
So I would like to...
But that's on the edge of it, not in the middle of it.
So can I have a proposal?
Post the reindeer. But you know, we also have the full accounts for the Christmas market for the next meeting.
Yeah.
We do approve the reindeer and get the deposit.
Can we have
proposing it? Second that then,
okay.
if that's the
all those in favour. Four, those against, two against.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's covered.
Sorry, Anna, just want to check with them before you actually book them. And
no.
then last year for the carol singing, St. Peter's had the reindeer in the church.
Oh, did they?
Mm.
Yeah, so you might like just try to check whether they've got
cheaper reindeer
or sheep with horns on it. Shave a sheep, put horns on it.
Yeah. My cat's available.
Yeah. I've got a black cat, does that help?
Does he need to grow antlers?
It doesn't align with St. Peter's dates, but
now,
you might like to check.
The next point is review Christmas tree lights. Now, Emma did say she's got a third quote this afternoon, but hasn't been able to go through it.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we need probably to put that back until the next meeting, so that we have a clear understanding.
Get it ready. It's just come in. I've literally printed it off. I haven't even looked at it. I don't know what the costs are or the difference.
But just to clarify, this is We buy the lights, they put them up.
There's a bit of hiring in right. there as well. So you hire a scheme.
Yeah,
and then they put it up, take it away, check it. Mm-hmm. And then also with the other two companies, I've got to check with this one. They've also incorporated our lights that we already own.
Well, yeah, that's what we're going to say, because I read that. One of them incorporated, one of them didn't.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we're going to have to look at that, because obviously the one that did incorporate work was actually cheaper, but we've still got a lot
of But it's a nice, third, I mean, yeah, it's a nice idea.
So just tell me that again. So we've got some lights.
Yeah.
We want some more lights.
We've got some very old lights.
Yeah.
We bought some new lights last year.
Yeah.
So the thought was that the new lights that we bought, we would incorporate with the hired scheme as well. So we can still use some of our lights. And I think one of the quotes, I think he did take some money off.
Mm-hmm.
Because he said, I've forgotten you've got those lights. So
For instance, the Christmas tree lights, we bought them last year.
Yeah.
So they're new, so they can be reused. And one of the quotes in here actually did take into consideration the fact that we did own our own lights, and therefore they would use those, put them up, take them down, and we would keep those lights here, but they would then take the ones away that they have.
Well, we're talking here.
But can I just say
£15,000 a year?
Well, that's about right,
yeah.
Isn't it? That's what it was last year.
Well, no, we bought the lights last year.
The cost of
putting them
putting
up.
Putting them up and everything was still a lot.
Yeah, it's a huge amount of money.
Yeah.
Terrific.
Mm.
So, but we haven't got the third estimate here, and I think it's possibly a good idea if we have all three estimates together so we can judge before then, rather than sort of vote on the two we've got tonight.
It's got to go to full council anyway because of the amount of money.
Exactly, yeah. So we can only recommend which one it is.
Mm. But haven't we got the same problem as with the reindeer? Because if you don't book these people well in advance,
I mean, obviously, one of the companies is a company we already use, so they technically will know. But the other two, now this one that we've just got, and they do Thrapston's lights. I don't know if anybody can remember what Thrapston's looked like last year.
They were really nice.
Yeah, I did hear a few things where they were quite nice.
They were a lot nicer than ours.
And I haven't looked at the costs on that, but this company that we have come in, this guy, he does it, they get the lights in and they actually install it themselves. The problem with the company that we use at the moment, not problem, but...
Is that light?
Light.
Yeah.
They subcontract the installation, which I think they bumps up their costs a bit.
Well, which is why we looked at doing. This is why we looked at doing new lights this different company this year, because if you remember, some of the lights didn't work.
Mm.
For instance, the trees near the bus stop on top of North.
We've had that every year because 2 years ago we had the section down West Street from Beans down to beyond the QBH didn't come on.
Mm.
So we've got to make sure this year
we actually had a guy upstairs in the QBH trying to sort out a connection and trying to get that section of lights on while the Christmas market was going on all around him.
I think what we've got to do is get the third quote in, go through it all properly, correctly.
Yeah.
Ask questions this time about what happened and why it happened last year, and what, for instance, the people that do it at the moment, what they're going to do about it if we employ them again, and what guarantees we can get from the other companies as well. Because I don't really want the same situation where we have, you know, businesses complaining because the lights weren't switched on.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we have quite a lot of that.
But the basic premise is if we get company who we hire lights from and they put them up, or any problem is all their problem, isn't it?
It's always a surface level contract, aren't we?
It took 2 or 3 days to get them back, you see, and that was what was
that's wrong.
Mm-hmm. You see.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so can we defer that?
Mm-hmm.
Right, to the next one, the cemetery benches. Now again, I've read through this. And it looks to me, and I've mixed up my paperwork here, that the best value one is the one at £249.
Is that the plastic one?
No. That's the one, isn't it?
That's the plastic one.
Yeah, it is cheap.
But they're paying the whole cost themselves, I think.
No, there's two items here.
The one at £259 says that it's a £70 reduction, and the other one was basically £70 dealer.
How much is the plastic one?
Hang on, I'm trying to find it now. Tom, I mixed up my paperwork, didn't I?
There is, it's not wood, it's plastic, that one.
For a small amount of extra cost now, we've got benches up in a field in Cumbria that have been there 14 years now, and they look just...
I think there's some plastic ones along Blackthorn Road.
You can't move them, and there's no more maintenance. And over 10 or 15 years, they're much, much, much cheaper.
So we're going to go for the 329 or the 249. One's cheap, finished plastic.
I'd propose the 329.
I would second that.
Well, we've just blown the maintenance budget for the cemetery.
How many?
We need five.
Can we stage it?
Have we got a...
It's going to be within our approval. Sorry, what was the budget then?
£1,000 maintenance.
Why do we need five?
Because they're there to replace the existing ones that are there.
Could we stage it over 2 years?
That are in a bad way. But yeah, you could do it that way. But like you say, you are blowing the budget.
So is it, you know, coupled with the other item where we've got the chap wants to put a dedicated bench in there, so it opens up the conversation that so many people want to dedicate benches to that. Can't we, you know, even if we do end up paying for them, can't we get them as, you know, we can have them dedicated? And we'll try and win that way. Because then we've got the additional issue is the style of that bench that we're going to come up to next. It's not in keeping with these.
For a donation, have the name or name of a relative on it.
Well, on the Eames dedicated one, they wouldn't want that torn out already.
No, it's only the ones that are in absolute terrible state.
So it's not all of them?
No, because there's, when you get in the middle of the cemetery, there are three in a sort of area. I mean, they're in quite decent condition. One looks very similar to the ones that are all, the newer ones that are over there.
Yeah, I don't know which one they dedicated. I think it was up the top.
We could put an advert out saying, would anybody like to?
We could put it in the Handel advertiser, in our Handel page.
About the state of the benches in Fairbairn Institute.
I know a lot of people don't know what to use the money to dedicate something, and you know, the bench doesn't necessarily have one name on it.
It's a particular location.
Yeah.
Two or three people.
Are we going to give people a choice, a free choice of what they put as their dedication? Or we're going to have a drop down list? Or
I think you need to approve.
There's a potential problem there.
Fairly standard wording, I think.
Somebody can put whatever they want on it.
No, they're saying we need to approve. Yeah, they need to submit. So there's a bench been put in St. Christopher's Drive, and it came to this committee. Do you approve these wording?
Yeah.
And the committee approved the wording.
Okay.
Yeah, and they went on the bench.
The only thing I'll say is there are benches that look like this. They're not nice at all.
So can we go back then? So what we're looking at then, obviously, I take your point, Terry, about the budget. I think that was only £1,000. If we bought three of the more expensive ones, that would come under the £1,000. Mm-hmm. We'd then get three new ones there, and we also advertise that if you want to put a plaque on that, you know, we could talk to them about how much it would cost, mm-hmm. and any monies that was raised buys an extra seat. Mm-hmm. So we've got the five we need.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So we essentially we're trying to get the seats are all self-funded.
Exactly.
So we're covering the cost of the first three, and yeah. then we do the subsequent ones in the same way.
Exactly. So with a little bit of luck, we'll actually recoup the money, and we don't mm-hmm. sort of. Yeah. But of course, we do need approval of what the dedication is.
Yes.
You know, so it would need to be approved. I don't think the whole committee needs to approve it, but I think we should say Emma is a sensible person.
Well, in the past, it's come to this.
Yeah, it does come to
that.
It's a 3-minute item.
Oh, yes. Whatever. It's just that, you know, I just didn't think it was.
On the subject of the budget, I don't think we've spent a huge amount in recent years. I know that money doesn't carry over to the next year, that disappears at the end of the financial year into the surplus that is then allocated to reserves. But if we haven't spent a lot of money, spending a big chunk of it, or even slightly overspending it on this item, I don't think is going to be a problem, because the only other thing I can recall us buying was we bought some ultrasound units to try and keep the moles down at one stage. Yeah. We bought two or three of those. But other than that, I can't think what else we've spent.
Did they work?
They did.
Oh. They did. I think it's just been sort of general.
We drove them somewhere else, but they worked. They got them out of the cemetery.
That's
okay.
I suppose, yeah.
Send
them
down the boardwalk.
The only other thing is that on the budget, is there a budget for benches and things like that?
No, just maintenance.
So we just.
And that raises another point, doesn't it?
When we look at
So when we were walking around looking at it, we obviously didn't look at those.
Mm, yeah. I think
so. If we haven't looked at those, what else in our in our estates that have we missed? Mm. Oh, most certainly something else. I mean, just. Human nature, you're not going to see everything.
Mm. And people have dedicated benches in the town, and then when they've worn out, other people who are used to using them complain like Billy about the fact that we haven't replaced them. Mm. You know, you can't win.
No.
Well, we could set up a whole hive industry for Arundel Town Council, you know, with dedicated benches all round Arundel, only for 12 months. Then we replace with somebody else's dedication. I'm a businessman, Terry. I don't believe in, you know.
Are you going to rent space on the bench?
Yeah, rent space, you know. They do that in the States. If you look, they do that.
I can book this bench. Get up.
Yeah.
Okay.
You
sitting on. Right, so we're going to purchase three.
So
can we go back and say, are we agreed to purchase three?
I'd like to propose
Sorry, I've got the question of clarity now, and we'll pour over this one again. The cheaper one is the full teak one, and the more expensive one is the teak finish. The cheaper one has a 12-month guarantee on it, and I can't work out that the more expensive says no maintenance. Mm. You know,
is that the one that's wood?
No, that's plastic.
The more expensive one is the one that looks and feels like teak.
Yes.
Yeah. So it is the one that says it's more durable.
Yes.
Is that the case?
And you have to varnish it, oil it.
I don't understand.
Is that the one we're going for?
I think they come from different websites, so the information on that page is different one way or another.
But it is say that the more expensive one is the one that isn't teak. Is that
that's
what
right.
we've
that's
right.
plastic. That's plastic.
Yeah. That's the one we want to go for.
Because it'll be
last time.
No, I agree with that.
Yeah.
I mean, the teak one.
Last
one. Formed pieces.
Plastic that looks like teak. Yes, what it is. Yes.
That's fine. Right.
You can unscrew the dedication and it's on the list.
Yeah. Right. And we've only got 10 left.
So we're going for three. Can we? Are you proposing?
Yeah.
I'll second it. All those in favour?
Right, okay.
I have a supplementary question.
Of course.
Who is going to promote the
dedication,
the dedications and getting in the money?
The marketing committee.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's already going to advertise next time. We've already done that. We're all over it.
Brilliant.
Pace it. Okay.
This is my declaration of interest, as I know the people.
To approve request from the former resident to replace bench number 7 with a new bench memorial plaque and relocate bench to a new position. Okay, well, two things I'd say about that. I've got no objections to the new bench. However, I would say that it has to be the same type of bench that we're ordering these three new ones, because we can't have lots and lots of different benches.
No.
Okay.
What happens when the one we buy isn't available in a couple of years?
Well, then we'll have to look at something similar.
The bench they're looking at is much nicer.
Well,
it's bigger.
It's more expensive, isn't it?
It's a 3-seater, so they're paying for it, don't
they? Yeah.
And that's plastic as well.
Recycled plastic.
Recycled plastic.
But it's a bigger bench. So.
Well, I think we'd have to. In that case, what I'll do is I'll take advice from the people in the room tonight. Do you want the same type of bench as we've already ordered, or do you allow this bigger bench, which is different, to go forward?
Well, the three that we're buying are not identical to the ones that are going to remain, because we're keeping some.
Yeah.
So I think you're going to have different styles. So I think you'd be hard pressed to say to these people, you can't have the style you've chosen, which is better and more expensive than the ones we're selecting from our own budget. I think it'd be hard pressed to say to them, no, you can't have that, you've got to have the one we say. Mm-hmm. And when you've got different types in there already.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So can I, in that case then, because I don't mind, can I ask then that we, somebody proposes that we accept the resident's request for this better bench and move forward on that?
It's not one that's already dedicated.
Get your hand down.
The one they want to replace is or move.
No, it's no. It would be none of the ones that are dedicated will be moved.
Right. So they're going to put a memorial plaque on. We need to put a rider in there that we need to approve the wording.
You are always in our hearts.
Can we, when we approach them, go back and say, you can have what you like, but we would prefer you to have what we're buying, and see what they say?
We can say that to them, yeah.
Yeah, I would like to go with that offer.
Yeah,
well, it would be nice if we had a bit of harmony in the cemetery, and this is one area.
The only thing with that might be is they're offering a larger bench, and they're offering recycled plastic. And in light of the discussion last week with Transition Animal,
I think
the circular economy reusing plastic and recycle is absolutely crucial.
Yeah.
So maybe the argument is we should buy better recycled plastic benches in smaller numbers each year.
We had actually this discussion not all that long ago, because we've got the bench in the marketplace, the commemoration bench, which again is totally different.
Yeah.
So we have actually got recorded decisions about this.
We are going to have different styles up there.
Yeah. Because every time we buy another one, there'll be another
model.
And there's one other issue, and relocate bench to a new position. We need to know exactly where they have in mind.
Is it not so?
They've told us where they want it.
Have they told us?
Yeah.
Is that the old bench they're suggesting?
Located at the very top of the cemetery.
Looking over the valley.
Yeah,
quite a nice place.
And I've got a feeling that's the one where the Eames's one is, which we want to move.
If there's a bench there that's got a plaque on it, it won't be moved because it's dedicated.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's any of these that are.
Okay, so again, because obviously time is not moving on. To approve, can we go back to this then, please, and approve it as is? Can I have a proposer?
I'm sorry, I'd like it approved with the option of choosing on a sort of bench, yeah, which is what Terry proposed. They have an option.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think that's necessary. I would say that we can put a bench in there, a different bench.
Yeah, but if we were doing it ourselves, we'd have all the benches the same.
Well, we're not going to get that anyway, are we?
We're never going to get that.
Oh no, we've just ordered three benches. We've got a fourth one here. Yeah, if we were ordering them ourselves, we'd order four benches the same.
You've got eight there in total.
Yeah, I'm just talking about these here today.
Yeah.
But to give these guys the option, if they want to have the same bench as us. Because if we wanted this bench, we would have chosen this bench for ours.
If they say no, is that okay?
Okay, yeah.
Well, that's fine.
Yeah. I'll
ask that question.
Right.
We'll propose it like that.
Yeah.
Okay. If they say no, we accept the bench that they've chosen.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right. Yeah. Can I have a proposal then, please?
I'll propose that.
Seconder?
I'll second it.
All those in favour? Right, that's that one. Okay. Traffic bollards at St Peter's. Mm-hmm. Now, I've had a look at this, and we've got metal ones, and we've got wooden ones.
Can somebody tell me, sorry to keep working over the past, but stuff like this, they've already discussed when that wasn't here. So can somebody tell me why they're our responsibility?
Well, that was the question I was going to ask, actually.
St Peter's Yard is our responsibility.
The
churchyard is our responsibility.
It is the churchyard, is it?
Yeah. And that's part of it.
Because it also protects the school, doesn't it? Because it stops.
But we tried to give it to the school. And
right. They won't accept that. Floating shortages. Okay. So we've got no choice. We have to do it. I've read the three, and I must admit, I would prefer to keep to the wood.
Yeah,
so it's more traditional.
Yeah, so what actually happened, Peter, it came to this meeting about 3 months ago, or maybe two.
Two.
Yeah, two. Yeah. That's a long time. Yeah, but it came 2 months ago with a proposal for plastic. I was concerned about plastic, and we thought we looked out there, but you know, replacing light for light. Just from memory, it's not just these bollards in the photograph, is it? It's the ones round the corner at the back of the church as well.
Down by North.
I think it's just these. Yeah, because I think these are the ones that when they try and lift them out, they've rotten.
Right. So, to my memory, when you go, you know, where the top door of the church is, on the right hand side of that door, there's an area where we were looking at bicycles, and there's some bollards there. Yeah, there's some wooden bollards there, so we just need to check that we've got
the quotes are all quoted for seven. Now there's six showing on there.
Okay. One so is it?
Yeah. These are the ones we're talking about now.
Right, okay.
So I think it's just those that we.
No, there's the missing one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the seven.
Yeah, that's the seven.
Yeah, so there's just seven.
That's the seven.
So it's just those there.
Yeah.
Okay. So, as I said, looking at this and looking. This, I actually thought the solid oak posts were the way to go because it looks the traditional. It's still, you know, it fits in with that particular area. But I don't really think we should change it.
No, that was my view.
So that's the cheapest quote.
But I've had another quote for £1,300 and I'm just looking for one. I can't remember.
Well, this is £1,230 plus VAT. From Nicholas Joyner in a minute.
Now he did the gates at the courthouse.
Yeah. And he's alright, isn't he? Mm.
Can't find the other one, but it's £1,300 to replace.
What, plus VAT?
No, it's not a VAT. I printed it out. He's not that registered.
Oh, right, okay.
And we've got plus one new balancing.
There's one of these missing.
Yeah, it's where that piece of metal is.
Yeah. It's here, if you look on your picture, there's a space with a metal plate on the ground.
Oh, for casting
that's been lifted by somebody.
I think it was all like for like. I'm just, I'm definitely reading this part, and I don't know where it's going.
Well, while Emma's searching for that one, can we approve the fact that we want wooden on the
telephone? Well, that affects the price, doesn't it? So
the wooden one is cheaper.
The other one was wood as well.
Oh, right.
Well, I don't want to be a party pooper.
I thought we'd made a decision more or less.
I don't want to be a party pooper, Mr. Chairman, but once again, I'm going to tell you you're going to blow your budget on the churchyard, which is £500 for R&M.
We're going to blow the budget on the church now.
Yeah, well.
We'll save the one, cheers.
Unfortunately.
We can't. There's not a lot you can do because they are rotting in there. Two and a half. That's two things we've missed on our journey round.
Yeah, that's why I've always thought the way we do our budget needs to be looked at in a little bit.
Well, can we propose that the committee would like to have the seven posts replaced in oak, but then we take it to the full council for their approval because it's over the budget for the churchyard.
Yeah, I think that sounds the right thing.
Just the idea is to make sure
we've got to have it approved in any event.
Yeah.
I've got the other quote here. It's supply and fit 7x oak post measuring 1.2 metres by 165 millimetres in structural green oak or prime air dried oak, plain finish with 4-way weathered top as per existing posts.
None of these is over the 2.5 grand or whatever that we've got limit for here, is it?
No, but this is, it's according to, sorry, Terry is the
budget expert, that we've got for budget. R&M in the churchyard is 500 quid.
Yeah.
So we're overstepping the budget.
We're overstepping the budget, but yeah, it's still within our approval to.
So what we have to do is, we approve it, but we need permission from General Reserves.
Where are you going to get the rest of the money from?
We've got an estate budget made up of lots of little figures because we put in provisional sums every year. I mean, a lot of years they don't get spent, but some areas do and some areas get overspent. And that's a couple of areas where they're overspent, but there'll be other areas where we've got money in as a cover where we won't spend it. I can't think of one at the moment, but it will happen.
One thing?
I mean, for years we had... We had a tiny amount on Joan Strong Centre and never spent it, something like £500. And then one year we put a large sum in to do that porch.
Yeah, the porch.
And that was a one-off sum, and we put a large sum in to cover that because we knew that was going to be a specific item. I agree with you, we should have budgeted for these in the first place, more accurately.
But if you don't know that it's going to happen...
But that's going to happen with an estate's budget. You are going to find yourself with something that needs repairing. You're not going to say, we're going to let it fall to rack and ruin because we haven't got a budget for it. We'll leave it till next year and put it in next year's budget.
No. Yeah. I agree. And often leaving stuff costs twice as much when you've saved up the money next year.
Yeah.
I agree.
So I think swings and roundabouts is what I'm saying.
But also as a council, you should set your budget and you shouldn't be going over your budget.
Well,
can I do two things? Firstly, we're going to approve the fact that we want or we have to replace them in the new wooden posts. Secondly, we're going to go to full council to ask for the difference in price so that we're not blowing the budget. We can ask for a general increase in price or general purse. Mm-hmm. And thirdly, I think, as you can clearly see, I'm not au fait with everything that goes on and budgets that are in the estates. I will sit down with Emma before the next meeting and get a handle on all the budgets that we have so that I know what I'm talking about next time. Is that okay? All I'm saying is, I need to make sure that we get it all right. So, we agree in principle to replace the... seven wooden poles or posts. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you, have you, do do you want to specify who you're going to go with?
Well, we've got two quotes. Is that right? Yeah.
Nicholas Joyner, who we know, and who's the other one?
DC Construction.
And where are they based?
Yeah. I'll just put it in somewhere.
I've never heard of DC Construction.
You're right time, aren't we?
It was the one that was £1,300, seven posts in green oak or pine oak, dried oak, plain finish with four-way weather top.
Okay.
Including the blanking cap.
Yeah.
Yeah, four-way weather top as per existing post.
No, the cap that Councillor Cheshire was talking about.
That's an extra £174 on this.
Yeah, we'll have
that. Yeah. What do we need a cap for, sorry? To stop replace...
Stop the rainwater going in the wood.
Yeah, it does. That one doesn't say anything about that.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, so you're talking about the cap on the
floor. The four-way weather top, is that what?
No, it's the actual...
The cap on the floor.
Yes.
The cap on the floor, yeah.
Yeah, I haven't got that.
I'm just
yeah. We need one of those.
See? Right, okay, I haven't got that on there, but I think the other one does.
Well, no,
the other one does,
yeah.
Well, there's an extra.
And then cost, yeah.
We have to have one of those, because if we take it out...
So, can we say then, we go back to this gentleman that's quoted the £1,300, and check how much it would cost extra for him to put this blanking cap on. Is that what it is? Blanking cap? It's a blanking cap. That is a K, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, it's a blanking cap. Is that okay?
Yeah,
that's whereabouts does he live?
Rock Road.
That's, well, you see, and I'm one of these people that believe in trying to use Arundel people for maintenance of Arundel Town Council rather than others. So if he can come back with a
positive advice. Yeah, he's done work.
So, you know, should we use him?
Yeah, but
depends on unless he's going to charge us a normal leg for the blanket.
If not, we go with the second quote, which is the Nichols.
Well, by the time it's going to full council anyway,
that's fine. Okay, so let that go now. Right.
Did we vote on that?
No, it's to review. It's not to vote.
We were getting somewhere. Could somebody check around the back of the church then? Because I do know there are wooden stakes around the back of the church, and that's the ones I thought we were replacing.
Right.
So it would be better to be replacing these, and then,
We'll have a look.
Yeah.
I'll walk up tomorrow.
So it's it's when you go up the side path to the church opposite the school.
I don't go past the church. In fact, I've only been in that church twice, and that was for Arundel Town Council.
I think these are the ones. We've got the right ones.
Yeah, we've got the right ones.
Some more.
I'm not sure there are. I go past it every day, and I don't think there's a book. It might be there.
It might just be turning the tide.
I'm going so fast on my mind.
Right, now, to approve the hiring...
You won't know.
Gentlemen, ladies, to approve the hiring of the QVH for live bands. Any comments?
Well, I don't see anything against it. Unless we've got our neighbours complaining.
But we have parties and that there anyway, weddings, parties.
What's the difference? Do we have to get an entertainment license or something?
No difference on that front at all. We've had to do an extensive amount of work, well, Rebecca has, on working out how many people we can have in the building where it's safe. Fire.
What's that number?
It's 200. Yeah. There's a lot of to-ing and fro-ing, and there's lots of things about calculating your exits and how big they are and how many you've got. So we've got it 200.
And how much are we getting from it?
Just normal rental.
It's a new sort of startup.
Yeah, I know. I just like to see.
I mean, I think it's. lends itself.
Well, there's headbands, isn't there? I can't see what the... Okay, so can we...
I think it's because of, it's more about making sure that we've got the right number of people, making sure that you're aware of it, so on the night when you get loads of people ringing you up complaining, you don't sit there and say, I know absolutely nothing about this.
Okay, so can we approve this, please? Can we have a proposer? Right, all those in favour? That's approved.
Thank you.
Right, to authorise refurbishment of the co-op car park toilets.
I didn't need the photographs.
Sorry?
I didn't need the photographs.
You would have been in.
No, I wasn't. I wouldn't have gone in, but
I'll go in there again.
You know, it's like that.
Pretty accurate. Good photos. Yeah. Right, so are we saying yes?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Can I have a. No, actually.
Is there a cost?
We've not got that far yet. We just want you to let us go and get some
principles.
So are we voting on this?
Well, you can just say, I can just put down you all agree.
Are we agreeing to this?
We really ought to call it the council car park because it is the council's car park, it's not the co-op car park. Apart from, they are supposed to maintain, cut the bushes and maintain.
Yeah, and mark the lines on the car park.
Yeah.
Sorry?
And apparently mark the lines on the car park as well.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. So. We should be writing to co-op about that.
Doesn't it? If we put council car park, nobody would know.
Let's put the council car park Pacific Coast Line.
Yeah.
Before we blow it, how much budget have we got on the car park toilets?
Oh, grand, I think.
Well, we've not got a cost yet.
No,
but I said before we do, before
didn't we put something in? Because didn't we look at these in summer?
Yes, we did say there was something a bit dirty. Okay, but it's worth finding out what's. We've got to find out the cost before we can approve it.
Yeah.
This is just to authorise the
I think we took some, when we did the budget, I think we took some money out of reserves, £4,500. Comes to mind.
Okay. Right, next one is to approve the replacement of the damaged street lighting at LC18 located on the footpath of Wentworth Drive.
Did somebody run into it with a
vehicle? It does look like it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's a massive damage.
Yeah, I would say that's what's happened there.
And isn't this an insurance?
I don't think it's
handled.
Only if you can find the vehicle. Our insurance.
Mm. Oh, our insurance.
To be honest, £650 commercial insurance, quite frankly, would bang your premiums up by at least 50% if you did it on insurance.
I also don't know how, I think it's been like this for some time as well.
Okay.
I agree that we should be,
but the problem is nowadays, Val, and you'll know it really, well, not so much from your house insurance, but car insurance, the excess now is going up so much, and by the time you reach that excess, the amount you lose on the premium
payment. I appreciate that. PE8 is a really, really bad.
It is, isn't it?
It's going to be, and it's the hottest spot in the country, my car insurance people told me.
Yeah.
Full car theft.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Okay, I will contact the insurance company. Yeah, they may just say, yeah, that's fine, yeah,
yeah,
we'll
get
it
worked
and we'll do it.
Do we know how many streetlights are our responsibility?
I do, but I
can't. I didn't know anywhere.
Yeah, well, recreation ground.
Okay.
Rockingham Hills, where this one is, we've got some. We haven't got many, and the ones in the churchyard. We haven't got a lot in the scheme lights we've got.
So we need to be looking at those when we do our rounds.
So, can we approve that, please?
Yeah.
Although, can I have a seconder? All those in favour? Is that one done?
Was that for both?
No, that's the second one. The second one is to approve the transferring unmetered supply to a new column at a cost of £409.
That's part of this.
It's a part of it, but it's a separate approval.
Yes.
So can we approve that one as well, please?
Proposed.
Second. All in favour? That's done. Thank you. Right, to remove quotes for new CCTV.
Again, I think this is another one where you've currently got two quotes, one by a company that we already use, that already maintain the ones in the town, but the COVID company that was supposed to be going to give us a quote, which is this one, they haven't got it to me in the town, so again.
So do we leave it until the next?
I would, yeah, because I think it's worth getting it.
So
I'm losing the plot a bit because I thought we'd approved this a long time ago.
No, I remember in the council we actually approved a new CCTV.
Right. Oh yeah, for in here, I think probably you're thinking about monitors, the three.
Yeah, the ones in the town centre, yeah. Because we were talking about the angles of view and.
Yeah, we improved it. We agreed to improve it, but we didn't improve any costs or anything.
I thought we did.
We put something in the 3-year plan.
We wouldn't have approved without knowing the cost.
No, okay.
Yeah, and I don't know, I think there were a few questions raised.
Okay, so
and I think there were a couple of issues with the two quotes we've got. They weren't exactly like for like, so I think Lisa went back and asked a few more questions. But like I say, this one hasn't come through, so.
I'm confused with this, Emma, because on the front page, first of all, it looks like we're having 11 cameras, but I think that's 6,400 quid. But then on the second page,
it goes down a little lot, doesn't it?
There are two options, and they're a lot less than that, so I'm confused.
I haven't got.
Is that one camera on the first page? 6,380.
No, that's all cameras that we've got down the town.
Right.
And this was in the back room stuff, isn't it?
So what's on the second page? Is that something different?
Video recorder.
Sorry, I'm not quite sure what
you've
got. Well, no, she's something
I haven't got.
I haven't got
it.
It came to one and option two.
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking then.
Maybe it's not the same people, is it?
Yeah, this is right. That's this. Yeah, that's the second quote.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's CBL, that's Marlowe.
Right.
Marlowe currently maintains the CCTV here. This company maintains the CCTV in the courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, we're going to get a quote from them as well. But CBL, the company that currently maintains all the ones in town.
Right. Okay, so moving on. Right, to approve the style of replacement barriers in West Street opposite the Ship Inn. Now, you've got three photos there. Who wants the more artistic one? Who wants the really plain one? And who would like the heavier, bulky one?
The blue.
The super bling.
I think the first one, is it more in keeping with what's there at the moment?
Are you talking this one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think
square joints.
Square,
yeah. It seems to look like what's there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not quite sure why it is. That all looks too simple.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's too plain, isn't it?
Is that what we've got?
I think so. But I'm not sure. That's a million.
Actually, this one looks like the way Lucy used to get in the foot top. Oh, you're too young.
I'm
the
too
50s
young.
And 60s.
I wouldn't know
about that. You jumped over them on it. Yeah, no, never mind.
And I've got a towel room that looks like
stolen. Cancelled somewhere.
Yeah.
So are we going for the square one?
The one with the square.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
that.
Right, so can we have a vote on that? We've got to approve it.
Propose it.
Second it.
All those in favour? Mm-hmm. Done, smashing. Right, so see April Action Plan and Progress Update. We've received that, so we don't really have to go through it, do we?
It's worth going through them one at a time. Just put through them.
Right. the copy under that.
I gave it to you, yeah. I printed it one out. Let me answer that.
It's
got
the
it's
a
spreadsheet.
Yeah, somewhere.
The
amazing thing is that these are more scrappy. Right, okay, so we've got the Estate Management Committee Action Plan.
Yep.
So, St Christopher's Drive, email tree surgeon and resident to inform council decision, request quote for TS for amended works.
I think actually I've since heard that we've had a couple of people look at it and they actually, although that big branch came off, they do think that there is work needs to be done, but it's not urgent work, mm-hmm. but it will need. And so I think we are going to get a quote because it will be a significant amount of money that will most probably blow the budget on.
Maintenance for St Christopher's Drive.
No, I think we've put an extra bit of money in for trees because.
Well, we've agreed that the survey is going to be for the whole of Andal, haven't we? Which that is one of them. I know he was around.
It was a case of whether we've got to get it done immediately because it's a very large tree that's very close to a house.
Mm. Well, it's people walking under it is the big risk.
Not in St Christopher's Drive. I wouldn't have thought anybody walks down there. Sorry.
Not with a mic going on.
Why? Oh, right, FH okay.
Drains.
Yeah. The drains. The quote, have we got a quote for that?
They've not come through yet with quote.
Okay. Request from Arnold WI.
I think it's just for the
television one. So we said that they wanted a raising stand and we said a bracket.
We're still put something on the wall.
So it'll be a picture of a.
Right. The survey and risk assessment. We've emailed to book a suitable date for the survey to take place. Do you know when that date is?
What survey is this?
It's the tree survey and risk assessment.
No, I don't.
Okay, so we're still waiting on that.
Oh, well, I don't know. Lisa may know.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Right. 62 Glatform Road, grass verge erosion. Glatform Road, 62. Where is 62? Whereabouts is 62?
It's where there's been a house either renovated or. And is it one that.
They haven't dropped the curb and they're driving over it. Oh, right, okay.
So there were complaints by the neighbours about the state of the curbs for people driving over it. The people, when we approved the parking in front of the house, the condition was that the curb should be dropped and it should be paved.
Yeah.
They haven't dropped the curb and they haven't paved it. So we need to go back to them.
Yeah. I think Lisa was going to chase this up through planning.
Yes. Is that the responsibility of 62 Glatform Road or the ENC Council?
It's the 62 Glatform Road. They would have to pay the council to drop the curb and pave the road.
Right.
And they haven't paved it. So the neighbours are complaining, it's a mess.
Right.
It is.
Mm.
So are they actually driving over that then to get to their drive?
Yeah.
They've got like 3 or 4 car widths.
Right, okay. In that case, then we should block it off until they've done it, don't you think?
The district council will inspect it.
Yeah.
Okay. FH, automatic lights.
Yeah, so the proposal here was to take the automatic lights out, put manual ones in, and we said we would like to get the automatic ones fixed.
I think, we're going to get the original company that put them in to come out and have a look at them.
Yeah. Because just in terms of our sort of energy stuff, the automatic lights are much better ecologically.
Yeah, because of the metal.
And they do stay on, don't they?
They've got a life of their own, they do what they want.
Yes.
Mine never come on.
Swimex and CWA, we've got the seasons to dealing with that, so we shouldn't have to spend anything.
CWA's lease is now done.
Yeah. Lease amendments to Jones Strong Centre lease.
Yeah, that's.
Yeah, I was confused by the lease, and I'm saying, you know, let's just get on with it and don't ask me again.
Can we have that in writing?
Well, I mean, our solicitor writing amendments to a document that their solicitor had written, and I just got totally confused on who was writing to who about what. So just.
I've gone back and it's hopefully going to start moving again.
War memorial information request, TC email details to the committee. What was that about?
I asked a question. In our accounts, the war memorial was valued at £1. It's one of these nominal things that's in our accounts, because we bought it from ENC for £1. That was your answer, wasn't it? And you have had a valuation on it for insurance purposes. And you've also had another valuation for something, haven't you? I forget what that was, but we don't know what that figure was. You didn't tell us that figure, but...
When did you ask them for that figure?
You stated that you'd had two valuations on it, I think.
It has been valued, it's... you're talking about the asset register list that I produced, where it's down for £1?
It's there and it's in the accounts, in the Sage accounts, it's £1 as well.
Your asset register has to be £1, even if it's got a bigger valuation, because that's how we got it for it, it's £1.
Right.
What's in the valuation? I've got 22,000 in my head, which I think is possibly what it's
I think that's the figure you've got for insurance. Mm.
You've got the insurance value is 221,000.
Yeah.
That's a rebuild.
Yeah. Valuation was 2017.
Can I ask a question? Because again, obviously, if it's in our books at £1, but it's the reconstruction of it is £221,000, how sure are we that the insurance company would actually do the reconstruction and not just give us £1 for the valuation?
Because they've revalued it, and that's what we pay our insurance.
Right, that's what the
rates say. No, that's all right.
The pound is purely for the asset register.
Yes, okay.
That's not the insurance list.
And that's how much it's passed to us. Mm.
No, that's fine. As long as the insurance does cover the real estate.
Yeah, they
insurance companies are really good at saying, well,
we've got this for
£1. Valued at £1.
So you are. You've been knocked down.
Yeah, exactly. It has happened, believe me.
No, right. They are valued.
Courthouse cost increase in utilities. TC emailed explanation to the committee.
I said that some of the costs seemed different to the previous years, and I think electricity was one, and asked the question, was that because we used electric heating when the boiler broke down in the winter? And I think you responded saying that you'd had an increase in some costs.
It's been fully occupied for the last 12 months.
Yeah.
Increasing costs for utilities, you suspect that.
Yeah, well, because it's full capacity,
the year before, but we've obviously had some. So those costs would.
They've also gone up
in
the last 12 months.
Yes.
The cost of electricity has gone up.
Yeah.
Significantly.
When you look at the income figures and the expenditure figures and compare the two, we'd gone from a virtual break even last year to last year in our end of year accounts, we were in the red. So
there was a lot of expenditure as well on that roof expenditure.
That was the year before. That was the year before the roof was. But we spent money on those doors, those wooden doors.
Last August.
Yeah, because of that problem with the roof last year.
Yeah, it's about £12,000 on the roof last August.
Was that in the last year?
Yeah.
The year before, I'd say. I bet the quotes and it started being talked about the year before, but the actual work wasn't done until August last year.
Because we talked about that before, right?
So we didn't pay the invoice until August last year, so that is in the current...
That would account for it, that's fine, yeah.
Okay, and then report of ongoing issues with the ballet students. It's got an email ballet instructor to remind students of procedures.
Yeah, they were getting changed in the cafe, so it was just to use their facilities and taking it on board.
That's fine. Okay, so that's dealt with that then. Right, so we've got that done. Any other business report, please?
All I've got is what I mentioned earlier about the British Legion will be commemorating a number of events, a number of key anniversaries this year and in future years, because we're now coming up to, this year is 75th anniversary of D-Day next week, on Thursday next week, and we'll be laying another wreath. We've got Kohima in Burma coming up 22nd of June. We've got some others coming up. I think we've missed Anzio in Italy, but we've got a number of them coming up. And there will be, each year, there'll be 75th, and of course it's also the 80th anniversary of the beginning of World War II this year. So there are a number of key anniversaries, big round numbers, where we will be commemorating at the war memorial and laying a wreath. So I just mentioned to the clerk earlier that we asked if all the wreaths could be removed at Easter, except for the Royal British Legion wreath, which should be there on its own till November when we put the next lot of wreaths on. But there will now be wreaths going on the war memorial, and just to advise our maintenance team that they will see new wreaths going, and the reason for that.
Can I ask, do you need any help from the council in regard to making it safe for people to actually do these little parades and memorial stands on the dates?
It would be handy if we had people, as we've had in previous years, on the 11th, whatever day the 11th comes on of November. We have that thing at 11 o'clock, that service at 11 o'clock, which only lasts 5 or 10 minutes. But we have volunteers from the council in high-vis jackets just to stop the traffic. That would help. If we can't get that, we thought we'd stand on the cobbled stones, actually on the plinth of the war memorial. If there's only a few of us, we can do that there. But it would be handy to stop the traffic, because if you do get things like buses swinging round that corner, they are likely to whip us off the plinth of the war memorial as they come round.
In that case then, should we two things: ask volunteers to stop the traffic, write to Stagecoach saying that on the 11th day of the 11th hour there will be a small ceremony at the memorial, and ask them just to delay the bus for half an hour.
You won't need to delay it for half an hour. It would be, we only hold them up for about 5 minutes.
Well, okay, 5-10 minutes.
It's 2 minutes
silence. So in other words, so that they understand that there might be a delay at that bus station near Beans.
Yeah.
I think it would happen automatically.
Ask if we can report if there's a repair cafe that Transitionary were running in July.
Yes.
And what was we, if we could somehow help them not pay the full fee for rental, if that's the sort of thing we're going to support with the environmental policy in the long run.
And we're doing that at the Hub or the QVH?
They're doing it in here, but I can't.
I think we did talk about that in the last meeting, in the last council meeting.
Well, when we talked about helping out the repair cafe,
yes.
Personally, my view is that I would rather give them money out of our grants, mm-hmm. Whether it meets the rent or not. We've got a grant that we give them, because we have that ability to give grants.
That's the best idea. It's nice and neat, tiny.
Yeah, you don't set any precedent on rent.
Yeah,
on
I think that's a good idea. So if they want to apply to us.
Yeah.
If if you could get it sorted for the next finance meeting, because I've got about
loads.
No, this week after. A couple of weeks. Yeah, the grant form, but they are a bit tricky to find, so I could just email you one.
That'd be great. Thank you.
Can I ask, only because I don't know, I may have missed it, of the clerk, we've now got the downstairs room that was used on Wednesdays by the police. Do they still use it, or are they subletting it to the district council?
No,
or
the,
what's
the district council are in there.
Yeah.
I don't know, there's no money changed hands.
That's...
They're just using it.
Well, how come?
Because the police said you can, because we don't use it.
Right.
How many years have they paid for in advance?
5 years up front.
They paid five up front, and
yeah,
they've got another
2 years ago.
I think it runs out next
year.
Yeah.
Which technically, it's the same time that East North Hants will be no longer. So.
It was August 2015, I think, when they first moved in.
Yes.
Well, they are. Yeah.
Subletting is not allowed, is it, in our?
That's really why I asked.
Well, they're in there. It's a good service. It's better than where they were before, when they were sitting upstairs near our kitchen. And it is a good service, and it's very well used. But if you
based
want me to
good,
tell
them, I mean, I asked.
No, based on it's a good service.
Yeah. But we do have to be careful about setting precedents.
But it's not. I mean, that, you know, the reason I've not done anything much about it is because obviously looking at how much rent is left, the rent has been paid. We've got the money, and East North Hants, by the time there's something that we've got to talk about, there won't be, and it may all change anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's why it's just continued. Okay.
Any other questions, Emma?
The only thing I would say, having had 2 months now where we've been right on the wire and, you know, come up with new agenda items, to ask us all to get agenda items in early, you know, so they can be on the proper agenda. The onus is on us, isn't it, to tell.
I think it's normally on the bottom of the agenda when you've got to get the next one.
I tried to get it on, but...
Well, no, you don't know, the last one I had at the London.
Yeah,
you know,
and also
I
think you've been affected by bank holidays as well for this.
Complaining about me.
No, I'm not complaining about you. I did it myself 2 months ago. Yeah, I came in the last minute with things to put on.
Mm.
It's just a reminder. Yep. Staff are doing a good job.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I think we can close the meeting at that.
Yeah,
thank you.